In this video, we start to define and describe our calculations of pH and pOH. By far, the vast majority of calculations we'll do are pH, but it is helpful to also define pOH quantities. Sometimes we will use those. The pH of a solution is defined as the negative base 10 log. And this is only in here to clarify that, remember, there are two versions of logarithms. There's log base 10. There's also the natural log. This was used in chapter 12 with kinetics. In this chapter, we'll be using the logarithm base 10 function. And it's the negative base 10 logarithm of the hydronium ion concentration. And that concentration has to be in units of moles per liter. A little language lesson for you about where the phrase pH comes from. It's from either the French or the German, both for powers of hydrogen. So pH is a logarithmic scale, and our equation for it is written as pH equals the negative log of the concentration of hydronium. And essentially, shortcut version for you, because these equations are not on your equation sheet, anytime you see a lowercase p in front of something, it means you're going to take the negative log. And we'll be doing this numerous times for numerous quantities throughout the chapter and semester. So that p means I'm taking the negative log of H or H3O plus. Sometimes, however, it is possible to be given or to measure pH and then want to solve for hydronium from this. So you should also know how to manipulate this equation to solve for the concentration of hydronium. Realize in this equation, the first thing we need to do is to move our negative to the other side. And then I need to get rid of my log function. So since this is the log base 10, again, shortcut for you on your calculator, look on the face of your calculator, you'll see the 10 to the x function. And so that means to solve for hydronium in this equation, I raise 10 to the negative of my pH. And again, this is the inverse function of log base 10. So practice with your calculator. In pure water, we have already defined hydronium as being 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7. I want you to plug this into the pH equation in your calculator and see what you get. So again, plugging in 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 into this function, and what you should see is that we get exactly 7, which makes sense because we saw that this was in pure water, which is a neutral solution, so it makes sense that our pH would be 7. So interesting side note for you here. Notice that the 7 for our final value came directly from the exponent. Because my numerical value was a 1.0, my pH is exactly equal to that exponent. And so this gives you a great way to estimate your pH values. It should always be close to that exponent. So again, on this next slide, here are our equations and what we just calculated. Extra practice calculation, we want to find the pH of our solution of hydronium with a concentration of 3.4 times 10 to the minus 4. So again, plugging into our pH equation. And on the next slide, we're going to discuss a new rule for Sig Figs on our pH calculations. So again, remember, our estimate is that our pH should be close to 4. I don't have exactly a 1.0, and so this is where I start to get decimal places. But our pH should be close to 4. And so notice when I plug this in, I get, I'm going to keep extra digits here, 3.4685. So notice our pH is close to 4. That's what we predict. Now, our new rule for Sig Figs is, again, here's our pH calculated from the previous one. Since the exponent gave us the value close to 4 in front of the decimal, the sig figs in the value that we calculated are going to determine the number of decimal places. And so the rule that we use is the number of sig figs in concentration, or whatever quantity we're using for sig figs. The sig figs in concentration will determine the number of decimal places in pH, and vice versa. So if I give you pH that goes to 2 decimal places, that means your concentration of whatever we're solving for would go to 2 sig figs. So this rule works in both directions. Good advice here is never round answers until the very end. It can change your pH value if you round early, and I will count off for that. So keep extra digits until the very end. So for our previous problem, again, we had 2 sig figs in our concentration, so we're going to go to 2 decimal places in pH, and that is our final answer. So we defined pH, but we can also define pOH. And again, remember that little p in front of anything means we're going to take the negative log. So pOH means I'm going to take the negative log of hydroxide. And again, it might be possible that we're given the pOH value and want to solve for hydroxide. Same thing, we take the inverse function of it. So I want to solve for hydroxide here and move my negative over first, and then 10 to the negative pOH would give me my hydroxide concentration. One last equation that's very helpful is for any given solution, the sum of pH and pOH will add up to a 14. The 0.00 can be thrown in, but the key is that they add up to 14. Your sig figs would actually be determined from your pH or pOH here. With all of this information, one very common calculation that we do is that if we're given any one quantity, we can calculate the other 3 for a solution. And realize that there's more than one way to get there. So I'm going to go through one possible series of steps. Since I'm given hydronium concentration, I can calculate my pH directly from this. And again, as we're doing this, we're going to pay attention to sig figs and units here. And I forgot to mention on the previous screen, but pH is unitless. The P of anything will be unitless. So for pH, I don't need to worry about units. For my first step here, I'm going to keep extra digits. This pH comes out to be 7.8239. And I'm keeping those extra digits because if I want to calculate from it, I want to use this unrounded quantity. Now for reporting final answers, I do want to look at sig figs. So again, remember our number of sig figs in concentration determines decimal places in pH. So my final answer here would be a 7.82 for pH. The next step in my calculation, I actually like to go to pOH next. And that's because of this new equation where I know the sum of pH and pOH has to add up to 14. So manipulating this equation, 14 minus the pH will give me my pOH. In my calculator, I simply left my complete unrounded value and just used my answer to do the 14 minus on this one. So again, with extra digits, we get 6.1761. Because this answer went to 2 decimal places, my pOH is also going to go to 2 decimal places. And so that value will be a 6.18. For our last calculation here, that leaves us with hydroxide to calculate. And I have 2 options. I can either use my KW equation to solve for hydroxide, or I can use my 10 to the minus pOH. It is personal preference. Either one of these equations or setups will work. So it's just a matter of which one you think you'll remember and know how to use for a test or on your calculator. I am actually going to use the KW equation. So again, I want to solve for hydroxide in here. And so that setup is going to be KW divided by my hydronium concentration, which was given initially. So our KW constant and then divided by the hydronium concentration. One of the reasons I like this setup is I don't have to worry about carrying from previous calculations or previous numbers. And I'm going to round for 2 sig figs here because of both the KW and my given concentration. That is going to be 6.7 times 10 to the minus 7. And again, I'm solving for concentration, so I have to put my molarity units in here. This slide is a good one as a summary of the equations we've covered so far. So equations and what we've covered. The only extra note in here is notice I have pH written two ways. So I will always write hydronium as the substance we're working with acids, but you can use H plus. Remember, it's an acid that's giving off an H plus. And so this definition still works, but however, H plus, if that's floating around in water, would automatically attach to the water to form hydronium. And so that's why I use hydronium. This slide is a great one to practice. So the answers are left in your slides. You can check yourself. But given each quantity here, asked to calculate another one, make sure you know which equation to use and check that you're getting the right answer with the correct sig figs.